We start. Where is the starting point, please?
You start with.
Yes, I have to start here. This is the starting point, as well as here. Have to eliminate parentheses. So I have to copy everything in the order I see it. Don't change anything. I copy 4, I copy the brace, 3, I copy 5. Now I'm ready. So, well, actually, I shouldn't copy 5, but in a minute. So 5, because I cannot simplify in here, I have to distribute 5 to these two. So 5 times negative y is negative 5y plus 15 minus 9. Close the bracket. Copy this, copy this, copy 3. And now negative 2 times y is negative 2y, and negative 2 times negative 8 is positive 16. Do you agree so far? Now I have to eliminate this, but I have to combine like terms inside first.
Do you distribute the two, the negative 2 to the y and negative 8?
5 to negative y, negative 5. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So now I'm working inside, combining like terms first. So 4, brace, 3, bracket, negative 5y plus 6. Close the bracket, negative 3, and copy everything else without making any changes. So the only change from this step to this step was to perform 15 minus 9 and change it to 6. I did not do anything else. Everything else gets copied as is. Now, since this is a product, I will distribute, and the brackets will go away. 4 outside. Brace, 3 times negative 5y, negative 15y, 3 times 6, 18, minus 3. Close, negative 2y, plus 16. Don't do anything before you simplify inside braces. You have to combine like terms first. 18 minus 3 is 15. So then 4, brace, negative 15y, plus 15, close, negative 2y, plus 16. Only now you are allowed to distribute 4. 4 will be distributed to these two terms. 4 times negative 15 is negative 60y. 4 times 15 is positive 60, minus 2y, and plus 16. At this point, I'm allowed to combine like terms. Negative 60y, minus 2y, negative 62y, 60 plus 16, 76. But is it clear?
I just feel like we should have did a big problem like that before we took the test. And it didn't have to be as easy or as hard or as ever you want to put it, but I just feel like we should have got a taste of a long problem like that before we did the exam.
Okay.
Okay.
That's just fair. Okay. Yeah, and you got to think this is all intermediate math, so they're not going to have something as challenging as that. Maybe for homework, give us those challenging questions. Because it's like we should know how to do the basics because we do all of the practice on them sheets. So the homework should be maybe up the homework a little bit, make it more challenging. Just so we're more immune to it when it's time to take the test.
Okay.
Like, oh, I've seen this. Well, I understand this.
Okay. However, what I would like to say is that when we move on to the next class, if we only present the basic, when you get to the next course, you're going to encounter a lot of difficulty.
But that's what I'm saying, though. Like, this is the basic. That's challenging. This might be the normal problem for the next class or, you know, for the regular algebra. Give us a taste of our medicine before we get this, so that way it's no problem. It's like, oh, it's no sweat.
No, I was just trying to prepare you and be ahead of everything, but I understand. I understand your point.
I like that problem, though. It's intense. You know, it's challenging.
No,
this is kind of, once you teach this to yourself, you're like, that's easy. I like that problem.
Oh, well, but I understand the point and makes sense. Yes, Garrett?
Oh, this is like a while back, but you wanted everybody to take down that quiz.
You mean the quiz, Christo? Yeah, I forgot to, yes, I'll put it in. Thank you. Yeah, I returned it without recording it. Sorry about that. Very
Can
good.
Can you do number 8?
Yes.
Because I got that wrong. You want to sit here? I know myself.
So there was, can you show me that problem?
10 less than 5 times the difference of 2 numbers.
Right, so here it is. We just talked about that. So, when we read the question, it said 10 less than 5 times the difference of 2 numbers. 10 less than 5 times the difference of 2 numbers. Better?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Other questions here? Anything else?
Mm-hmm.
Number, what does it say? Can you read it? Yes. Yeah, let me remind you, a complementary x plus y equals 90 degrees. Supplementary, yes.
I did opposite. I was so
mad. Well, I gave everyone who did the opposite, I gave us at least 2.
I was so mad.
It's okay.
I realized that once you collected and I went back to them, I know.
That's okay. That's okay. I still understood that you forgot. You forgot the terminology, so I still gave minimum of 2 points to everyone.
I did it, and then I erased it.
That's okay. Next question, is there anything else?
It's B, 90.
Oh, yeah, thank you for reminding me about that. Some of you made the mistake of finding the least common denominator when multiplying and dividing. We understand that that is wrong, correct? When we multiply and divide fractions, we do not need the least common denominator. Multiplying and dividing fractions is always easier than adding and subtracting. When we add and subtract fractions with unlike denominators, we have to find the least common denominator. We have no choice, but not when we multiply and divide. Also, I saw in some of your tests something like, I'm just making this up, 2 over 5 minus 10 over 12 or 21. I saw you simplified 5 with 5 and 10 by 5. But this is a subtraction. We cannot do that. You are not allowed to do something like this. This is only when we multiply or divide.
I thought you said only for addition. I thought you said we can do that for addition, too.
No, never. We have to find the least common denominator. So you cannot do this.
Okay.
Like you cannot, for example, when 1/2 multiplied by 3/5, we don't need the least common denominator. You don't change this into something over 10 and this into something over 10. Because I saw that. You changed the first one with the least common denominator. You said this was 5 over 10. And then the second one with the least common denominator of 10, this is 6 over 10. You cannot do that. There is no need to find the least common denominator when multiplying or dividing fractions. The same thing, you cannot simplify like this in a addition or subtraction, only in a product, and not even in division, only in a product. So when I'm asked to do this, the common mistake here was 2 times 3 is 6 plus 2 is 8. So many of you wrote 4 over 3 instead of 8 over 3.
What number is
that? It's a, right.
What number is that?
Can I see? It's B right here. Say it again.
Like you said, some people wrote. I'll admit I was one of those people because I was doing the positive times the negative, And then I did the, that's how I got the 4 over 3, or the negative 4 over 3.
So in order to put the integer back, you have to say 2 times 3, which is 6, plus 2 is 8. So negative 8 over 3. 3 times 6 is 18, 19. 19 over 6. And now a multiply when negative by a positive is still negative, so 8 over 3 does not change, but you have to flip 6 over 19. And of course you have to simplify by 3 first, and you will get negative 16 over 19. It will be easier because then it will be more complicated to simplify at the end, right?
Why wouldn't you do that? Why do you take the negative sign out?
I don't. I multiply the negative number by a positive number, and the answer is negative.
So I'm talking about the mixed number then.
So 2 times 3 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. With minus in front, negative 8 over 3.
Which
number is that?
Negative 6.
It's
negative 4.
It's a mixed number here. I wish
Any questions? Any questions? Is there anything else? Tim? I thought you had some questions. Are we finished with the test? Or, as I said, I wrote solutions and I will post them. I wrote solutions and they will be posted. Yeah, I scanned them and I just didn't get the chance to post them yet. Yes, Brielle? What does it say?
Negative 2.
And 2/3. Negative 2 and 2/3. Is this the one? No.
Oh, read
it to you.
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's the evaluating, it's the evaluating. So you're, oh, okay, minus the absolute value 2, negative 8, minus 3 cubed. Okay, I see it. So remember, the absolute value, we wrote this as a note, is not a grouping symbol. You cannot distribute anything inside the absolute value. You will multiply negative 2 by 16 and get negative 32 minus. In absolute value, you will have negative 16 and minus 27. You have to perform the operations in the absolute value, negative 16 minus 27, and you will get negative 43. Now you have to say the absolute value of negative 43 is, but there is a minus in front. Many of you distributed, said negative with negative, but that's not the case. This is the absolute value. You cannot do that. So this is negative 32 and minus 43, which is negative 70. What is it? Yes, negative 75.
What number is that?
Is the absolute value one. So please remember, you cannot say the opposite of something inside the absolute value. You cannot do that.
Right, because it's going to be negative 32 minus 43. That's how you read it.
No. If you consider this parentheses, you will say negative 32 plus 43, and that will be wrong.
I didn't say that.
No, I didn't say you said that. I'm just saying this is what happened in some of the tests. So some students wrote this. Because they consider the opposite of this will change it into positive. But instead of considering that this is not a grouping symbol, this is 43 and it has a minus in front and it has to stay.
So if that negative, if the 32 was a negative, would you still consider
it? It is negative 30.
I know, but if it wasn't, you still would not consider that 43 negative. Like it will. No matter what, when
the numbers outside there are whatever they do, they don't affect this.
Okay.
So even if I had or I didn't have anything, it doesn't matter. This is not connected to that. So it's connected by subtraction if you want, but it's not, it does not give, it does not reflect what happens in here. It has nothing to do with it. Better? Okay. Anything else? Is this okay?
Yes.
I did give partial credit for that. So because many of you got to this point and only had that mistake, nothing else. So I did give partial credit for that. Anything else? As I said, I posted solutions. I wrote the solutions, I scanned them, and I just didn't get the chance to upload them. I will. Anything else? Okay, let's go back to chapter 2, and Tim is anxious to give us some problems to work on. Oh, no, no, no. I don't put anyone on the spot. So I thought you had something. Maybe not. Okay, which section you have questions on then?
The equations about the numbers.
A page number or section number, anything that I can. You're on?
Page 122.
122, very good. Oh, it's solving for letters?
Yep.
Okay. This is on page 122, section 2.5, on page 122.
Were we supposed to do that in the section?
No, we didn't finish that. So let me just, I'm looking for my last lecture so we can browse it. Okay, so this is what we looked at last time, and there were some questions, and then solving equations for X and resolved identity contradiction and conditional equation. Again, we took care of fractions, and then problem solving 2.4, and we did as much as we could. And then we started 2.5, and we looked at a couple of examples, but again, not enough. Okay, so now we all know where we left it off. Good. So in 2.5, no, you are not responsible for 2.5 for today because we didn't finish it. I was hoping you would look at it, but it was not mandatory. So for example, if we look at 23, which is V equals, I think we did 23. Okay, so forget about 23. Let's look at, did we do 27, 28?
We did 27.
We did 27. So I'm gonna look at the end of the chapter and choose from there because I can make up stuff if you want. But give me a second to see if there is anything from that section. It's 2.5. Solve each equation is indicated. Yeah, on page 163, I'm going to pick 62. 62 on page 163. R equals VST minus 5. And we are asked to solve for S. What would you do first? Excellent, yes. That's what I would do. I would move 5 over to the other side. And I will write R plus 5 equals VST. And now I have to solve for S. How do I do that? Divide both sides by?
VT.
Very good. So I divide this side by VT, and I simplify, and I divide this side by VT, and I cannot do anything. So S equals R plus 5 over VT. Any questions on this?
Are you going to go over to this section?
Say it again.
Are you going to go over to this 5?
Yes, this is 2.5. We started last time. Here it was from last lecture, right here, 2.5, and we started with these formulas, and 23, And then we did 25 and then 27. So now we are continuing with more problems.
Number 54 on 163 is like that wire question.
Let's take a look. Which one?
Number 54, the 12-foot board question. The 12-foot board is to be divided into two pieces.
Yes.
Twice as long.
Yes.
Another x represents the length of the shorter piece. Find the length of each piece.
So what was the question?
Oh, I was just saying, I would like to do another one of those, but I got lost on the wire question. Kind of.
Okay.
Kind of like.
Yes.
So the problem 23, is that an actual problem?
Well, we solved it last time, and that's why
I
stopped.
Okay, gotcha.
So done. Done last time, and that's why I stopped.
Okay.
Okay, so there is a similar problem on page 163, problem 54. And let's take a look. A 12-foot board is to be divided into two pieces. So we know that we have 12 feet here. That's the length. It would be divided into two pieces. So I'm going to cut it right here. I'm going to call this Y, and I'm going to call this X. So this, the shortest piece is, I'm denoting it by X, and the longest piece I'm denoting it by Y. It's arbitrary. It doesn't matter. You can use A and B. You can use any letter you want. So it says one piece is twice as long as the other. Can anyone give us an equation that states that one piece is twice as long as the other based on the fact that I have X to be the shortest and Y to be the longest? The longest piece is
Y. Right.
Y is 2X. Is, yes, 2X. Very good. Is there another equation that you would write right away by simply looking at the drawing?
X plus y.
Very good. X plus y equals 12. We're going to substitute. What do I substitute and where?
X plus 2x equals
12. So I will replace this by?
2x.
Exactly. So then x plus 2x equals 12. Do you all agree with x plus 2x equals 12? Yes, everyone? So what do I have now? Very good, equals? Very good, and x equals? 4 what? Measurement unit? Feet. Then how much is y? 8. We all agree? So the solution is 4 comma 8. 4 for x. 8 for y. I don't trust it. What should I do if I don't trust it? And I should never trust it before what? Plug it in. So 4 and 8, 4 and 8. I have to check both equations. Is 2 times 4 8?
Okay.
Done. Is 4 plus 8 12?
Yeah.
So this is it. And no one can find another. So the shortest piece is 4, and the longest piece is 8. Could I have done this much easier? Maybe, but I need this for chapter 4. So I'm going to implement the seeds early. Systems. Systems of linear equations in two variables. Good. Any questions? Tim? Anything else? Are we better? Okay. So here is where we are right now. Yes, Brielle, anything?
That was easy, but I guess I was confused when you said we saw for like H, but then I guess
it's which one? Oh, that we are. I'm told that it says in the problem, you must solve for that.
Yeah,
they pick.
I guess
so. For that problem, we need to divide by 3. Go back real quick.
Which one? Which problem? Yes, I have to divide both sides by 3 to get 4. I'm solving this equation. I have to divide both sides by 3, and I get 4. Perfect. So would you like to see another, or?
Yeah, not at the moment, just
right, okay. So For example, 64 on the same page. Page 163, and we are given 3x minus 6y equals negative 2, and this I need for chapter 3, so it's a good example. And for this problem, we are asked to solve for y. How do I solve this for y? Yes, very good. So I have negative 6y equals negative 3x minus 2. Perfect. And then I want to get rid of 6. Very good. So negative 6y divided by negative 6 will give us, very good, equals. If you have any difficulties, take negative 3 over negative 6 on the side. Negative 3 over negative 6. When I divide two negative numbers, what do I get? And then 3 over 6 will be?
2. No. 0.5.
Yes, 1 over 2. So this is 1 half x. Again, if you have any difficulties, put it on the side. Negative 2 over negative 6. When I divide two negative numbers, I get? And 2 over 6 is? Sine? Plus 1/3. Very good. So we solve for y. So we are asked to solve for y, so I have to move 3x to the other side. And then I divided both sides by negative 6. Any questions?
Oh, I guess essentially, like, you're trying to solve for y, so you would move anything with L of y over to the other side of the equal sign. So you would try to get y by itself.
That's the question, yeah. We are asked to solve for y.
What if there was not, what if it was like 3y minus 6y equal?
You will combine like terms. Like we did in all the other equations. Yeah.
So if that were to be like,
but the more difficult situation is when you cannot combine and you have to solve. That's the more difficult. Because when you have like terms, you will combine them. Very good. Okay, so here's where we are, and I'm trying to go back and make sure that I touch up on each and every type of problem here. So we looked at problems including 28. So I'm looking now at problems 31 through 39. So let's look at 32, because I want to touch up on everything so you have examples from everything. So problem 32. Any questions here? Is this okay so far? Okay, so let's go back to page 123. That's 32 on page 123. For the purpose of purchasing lumber for a new fence and seed to plant grass, find the perimeter of the yard below. So we are given this yard. We are given 45 feet on the hypotenuse, 27 feet on one leg, and 36 feet on another. And we're asked to find the area and the perimeter of this yard. It's a right triangle. That is the volume of a solid, rectangular solid. Area of the base times the height. But here, first of all, let's find the perimeter. How do we find the perimeter? Yes. Yes. 27 plus 36 plus 45. What do I get? Okay. Measurement unit. Very good. Excellent. Now I want to determine the area of this triangle. And let me refresh your memory. Exactly. So it's 1/2 base times height. So here's the base. And this is the perpendicular, the height. Height and base. So let's put in the values. So what will you tell me to write? Of course, 1/2 in front, and then the base, which is 36, and multiplied by the height, which is 27. I highly recommend simplify. What will I simplify by? That's fine, but I want to simplify before I multiply huge numbers. But it's up to you. My suggestion is always simplify. It will make your life much easier, but both methods are fine. So I'll simplify by 2 and I get 18. And now I multiply 18 by 27. Measurement unit, please. Okay, you got, when you multiplied, 486. But you divided by 2, right? Okay, so it's the same thing then. Measurement unit, please, for area. That's for volume. Feet squared or square feet. Very good. Now we're asked to identify whether a fence has to do with perimeter or with the area, or and the same for grass seed. So fence and grass seed. Very good. Area. And the fence? Very good, of course. The fence is the perimeter, on the perimeter, and the grass seed is the area. Very good. So that was 32. Now I'm picking from other problems through 39 and 40. Let's do 40. Okay. The perimeter of a yield sign in the shape of an isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle has two sides that are equal. So the perimeter is 22 feet, they say. If the shortest side is 2 feet less than the other two sides, if the shortest side is 2 feet less than the other two. What is the variable? How do I denote the shortest side? What would you recommend? Yes, please. Sure. The perimeter of a yield sign in the shape of an isosceles triangle, which means these two sides are equal, is 22 feet. If the shortest side is 2 feet less than the other two sides, find the length of the shortest side.
Because those two sides are the same, can you just make a variable x?
Absolutely. That's all I was waiting for you to say.
Minus 2.
So what will this be?
That would be x minus 2.
Excellent. That's all I needed. So now I have to write an equation. Let's write the equation. How do I write the equation? Right. So let I go around the perimeter, x plus x plus x minus 2 equals 22. Excellent. And now I have to combine like terms. So when I combine like terms, what do I write? 3x minus 2 equals 22. The next step would be to write 3x equals 24. And the final step is to write that x equals? Good. And so this is 8 feet and this is 8 feet. Don't forget the measurement unit. What about the top, which is what I'm interested in? 6 feet. Very good. Okay, and that was problem 40. Let's see on the next page. 43, 55, 61, 63.
43.
Say it again.
Eight
minus two. Oh.
I heard you there. I was like, maybe I'm missing.
8 feet. So we divide both sides by 3, it's 8 feet, so 8 minus 2 is 6. Is that okay? I wrote it here, but not here for some reason. Thank you. My mistake. Okay. 55. Yeah, let's also do 55. It looks interesting. The perimeter of a geometric figure is the sum of the length of its sides. If the perimeter of the following pentagon is 48 meters, find the length of each side. So they're giving us this. I'm copying from the book x, 2.5x, and 2.5x. They're asking us to find x. So let's find x. Take a moment. And I'll take attendance in the meantime. And of course, I'm logged out. No surprise there. Erica, Tim, Nina is not here today. Megan, Bryce is not here tonight. Javon, Daniel, Rixi, Nicole, Hannah, Ryan, Nick, Tamara, Jidlaf, Shane, Sarah, Derek, Angus is not here. Garrett, Sean is not here, and Sylvia is not here. Okay. So do you have an equation for me, please? X plus x plus x plus 2.5x plus 2.5x equals 48. We combine like terms on the left. What do we have? So 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8x equals 48. So x is 6 meters. Very good. Okay, is there anything else? Hey, I don't want to miss anything. 61, 63. Okay. On page 125, find how long it takes a person to drive 135 miles. Do you have any questions for me one more time? Any questions? On I-10, if she merges onto I-10 at 10 a.m. and drives nonstop with her cruise control set at 60 miles an hour. How long it takes to drive 135 miles at 60 miles an hour?
We divide the miles by the amount per distance.
Right. So here it is. No, the distance divided by the speed. So here's the equation. Distance equals rate or speed times time. So I know the distance, which is 135. I know the speed, which is 60, but I don't know the time. So therefore, how do I get t? How do I solve this equation for t? Divide both sides by 60. So 135 divided by 60. And this is 2. What? Okay, so if T equals 2.5, first of all, the measurement unit. What is the measurement unit? We divided miles by miles per hour. So what is the measurement unit? Of course. So what does 2.5 hour mean? Well, and that's really not really important because she started at 10 a.m. So when will she get off I-10? At 12:30. 12:30 p.m.
Very. Let's say 2.5.
I'm sorry?
Is that 2.5?
I don't know. I didn't calculate. I will. Right now, just to make sure. Let me make sure. 135 divided by 60 is 2.25. Ah! So it's 0.25. Thank you for pointing that. I didn't even think. So 2.25. Two 25 is 1/4, so it's 2:15. 12:15. Very good. So it's 2 hours and a quarter of an hour. So you can replace this by 2 1/4. And we know that 1/4 of an hour is exactly 15 minutes. So that's why 2 hours and a quarter added to 10 o'clock is 12:15 p.m. Okay, ready? Now, the next section, I'm hoping you're going to like. So, percent and mixture problems. So, we're going to look at problems from 1 somewhere through 93. Okay? This is interesting because 2.6 in my book anyway does not have problems 1 through 93. It has problems 1 through 74. What about your book? Maybe my book is outdated. Okay, let me look again. Maybe I'm looking at something else. Oh, the pages are different. Oh no, no, the pages are not different. That's okay. But I don't, my book doesn't go beyond 74. Does yours?
Was it in section 2.6?
Yeah.
I only got up to 74.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. Again, so you can cross out 93. So 2.6, 93 does not exist. Okay. And I would like to pick a problem. Like, feel free to pick any problem you want after I pick one, and then you can pick the next. Ah, yes, I like 43. I just read it. 43 on page 136. So this section is 2.6. Let me make it clear. Percent and mixture problem solving. Percent and mixture problem solving. It's all about translating from plain English into different situation in mathematical terms, different life situations that we encounter every day. Now, before we even look at a problem, I want to make it clear. If I say to you, I have in my pocket 20%, what do I mean? What am I saying to you?
20% what?
Exactly. So 20% has no meaning. If I don't say 20% of what you have. That's 20% or not, if you think, if you say so. But what is the operation that is involved here? If I say, I have in my pocket, you have $100, and I have 20% of what you have. What is the operation that I need to perform?
Multiply.
We all agree with that. Yes? Okay, so if you have x, then I have, I cannot write 20%, I have to write 0.2 times x. So if you have x in your pocket, I have 0.2 times x in mine. Okay, that's one thing. Also, this is extremely important to remember this. This is the product. Now, one other thing I want to make it clear before we look at word problems. When we talk about 20%, we really mean 20 divided by 100, right? Which is the same with 0.2. Now, if I have, let's say, 3%, this is the same thing with 3, divided by 100, which is 0.03. What if I'm asked to change 1.03 in percent? Okay. So this will be 103 over 100, and that means, but this is the same thing. These two are the same. Okay. This equals that, 103%. Very good. So I think we should continue with reading problem 43. The number of registered vehicles on the road in the U.S. is constantly increasing. In 2009, there were approximately In 2009, there were approximately 246 million registered vehicles. This 136, 43 on 136. This represents a 3% increase over, I'm taking notes, I'm not doing anything else right now, over year 2002. How many registered vehicles were there in the United States in 2002? Okay, so let's talk about the problem one more time. Let's read it if we need to. And let's see what we have, we are given in the problem and what we're asked to do. Okay, so in 2002, there was a certain number of vehicles, unknown. Do you want to call it somehow? X. In 2009, there were 246 million. What I know is that from here, here, it happened to be a 3% increase over X.
What is the word right next to 246?
Million.
What's the word but 3%?
Increase. Okay. Yeah, it's right here also. 3% increase over 2002. So just think of it in these terms. In 2002, you had a salary. And that salary was increased by 3% in 2009. How much were you paid in 2002? It's the same idea. There was a number of X unknown vehicles in the United States in 2002. And when we looked again in 2009, we realized that it was a 3% increase from the original amount in 2002. What type of equation or how do I write something that I need to solve and get X? Hold on 1 second. You're on the right track, but let me just say one thing. 2x, I'm adding something to get 246 million. But what I'm adding depends on x. If I start with $10 and I increase the price by 3% of $10, then I end up paying But the, well, the point I'm making is that I'm increasing by 3% of the original. That's why we talked about that product situation of the of. So, yes, there must be a sum. 2x, I must add something to get to 46. But now I have to think about that something. How do I determine it? How do I write it? So how do I write this sum, this number, I should say? It's a 3% increase over x. They're trying to be tricky. It's actually 3% of x. So what do I write here? You cannot write 3%. That would be absolutely incorrect. 3% means nothing. Okay, so first of all, 3% is out. I have to write 0.03. 0.03 means nothing if I don't do what? By? Indeed. So to x, I'm adding 3% of x to get to 46 million. Is this clear? I know we need to practice this a little bit more, but is this clear for now? So you cannot add to x 3%. 3% means absolutely nothing. So you can add to x 3% of x to get to 46. Yes, go ahead.
Me?
I thought you had a question.
Okay, I'm like, the problem's not done, right?
Oh, no, we have to solve the equation. Yeah. So, well, but I'm just trying to make sure that we understand it. We cannot put something like this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now to one integer, I add 3 cents of an integer, right? 1x plus 0.03x. So please combine like terms for me and tell me what to write. 1.03x, 1 plus 0.03 equals 246. Final step, what do I do? Good, 246 divided by, so I grab my calculator, because I don't trust you anymore. Just kidding. So 246 divided by 1.03, and I got 238. I'm going to round it up to 39, because it says to round it up. So in the second, 239. Million. Okay, so the question, Siobhan, the question was, where do we get 1.03?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have X in your pocket, 1X. And I'm giving you 0.03x. So you have a dollar, and I'm giving you 3 cents. You have 1.03, right? Times x. And then we divide both sides by 1.03. Very good. Any questions on this problem? Okay, let's find.
Can you also
yes.
Figure out 3% of 246 and then subtract that 3% to get.
So you want to find 3% of this, but 3% is not on 246. 3% is on X. So this is the level in 2002, and it increased by 3% of this, not by the result. So the 3% is not connected to the outcome, to the output. It's connected to the input. The input is what we had on the roads in 2002. That number, yes, go ahead, sorry. No, that's
the. What page is this on?
Oh, yes, this was, we are on page 136, and this was problem 43. Is this, Tim, is this okay? So when you get an increase in your salary, let's say you're making 100,000 today, so you're getting a 3%, you're not getting a 3% on the outcome. You're getting a 3% on 100,000. And that goes up. Has nothing to do with the outcome. Okay?
Exactly what he was saying. I found, that's exactly what I did when I solved the problem. I found 3% of 246, I got that number and I subtracted. I got 238,620,000.
Oh, so what did you
round
you
it up.
You.
So I found 3% of 246.
Okay.
Which is 7.38. And then I subtracted 7.38 from 246. So I found 3%.
Oh, so you found the difference.
Yep. And then subtracted.
And that's probably, and then you round that up to 239.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I see what you did. But the 3% is on the base. It's on the original number. It's not on 246. So the outcome depends on X. So the 3% is on X, not on 246.
So I came up with the same thing.
So a number was increased
mm-hmm.
by 0.03 of the number. So that's how you get 1.03 of that number. And this result equals 246. So 1.03 times this equals 246. And that's why how we get this number is 246 divided by 0.103. When you divide 246, so when you multiply by 3%, you're actually multiplying by 3 and divided by 100. Okay, so you did 246 multiplied by this, and you got
7.38.
Okay.
And then I subtracted 7.38 from 246.
Okay, so 246 minus 7.38, and you got this.
238.
Right, I got the same thing because it's okay. That's.
So you can do that.
The same numbers as you did. You got like 7,380,000 or something like that.
Right. Oh, well, I don't recommend it because, one more time, the increase has nothing to do with 246. It is not applied to 246. The increase is applied to X.
Well,
don't
use the same for 246.
And
right.
That's fine. I didn't look in the book and see how they presented that. Well, you know what? That's a good. I doubt that they did that. I doubt. I would personally have never done that because the increase is on the base. It's not. It does not depend on the outcome. So it says most la, 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 la. So it screens if after 122% increase the number of, because I just opened the book. I didn't read this problem ever before. So the number of digital screens last year plus the increase, which is 1.22% of X, equals the outcome. So now they combine this into 2.22 and then they divide by 2.22. I don't recommend that method. Depends on the problem. I have to look at it again. But this is the method I recommend. Because the increase is on what you're having right now. Your salary is X, you have 3% increase, and then you get whatever. So it's 0.03 of X, exactly what they did. You add to X 0.03X, combine them and you divide both sides by this. And then this is what you started with. So you started with 16,000, let's as an example, and you ended up with your increase of 1.22 or 122% is 36,208. All right? Good. Moving on, let's pick another problem. Please feel free to pick if you want to. 51 just caught my eye. Before you choose. In 51, a company recently downsized its number of employees by 35%. 35% downsized. If there are still 78 employees, how many employees were there prior to the layoff? Still left 78.
35 by 70.
I don't go backwards. I don't recommend that. So this is the number of employees today. It was dropped by 35% of it. And the result right now is 78 people. So from this, we subtracted 35% of it to end up with 78 people. So can anyone give us the idea here? How do we write this, please? Yes? Yes. Excellent. X equals? That's it. From the original amount of X, we had a reduced it by 35% of it. Now from $1, I subtract 35 cents. What am I given? What am I left with, I should say? From $1, I subtract 35 cents. What am I left with? 65. 0.65x equals 78. How much is x? From $1, I subtract 35 cents. What do I get here? I have to write 78 divided by 0.65. So x equals 120 people. This was the original number of employees. It was reduced by 35% of it. And the result was 78. You can always go back and check. Here's how you check. From 120, you subtract 0.35 of 120. From 120, I subtract 0.35 of 120. And when I hit enter, what should I get? 78. Okay? Very good.
Does X represent the amount of employees laid off?
No. From the original amount, I reduced 35% of them, and I ended up with 78. Is that okay? Is that okay?
So you divided. How did you?
So, what is the question here?
X represents 100%, right?
X represents the number of employees that we had originally.
Okay.
We laid off 35% of them, and today we have only 78 people left in the company. So I have to combine like terms. From 1x, I subtract 0.35x, and I'm left with 0.65x.
So you used to have 120 employees.
Only 78 by subtracting 35% of the original number. Is that okay, everyone? Yes? Okay. I think we should choose another. Very good. Problem 40. A gasoline station decreased the price of a 0.95 cola. So the price was 0.95 of a dollar. It was decreased by 15%. Find the decrease in price and the new price. So the original price is 0.95. We reduce the price by 15% of it, and we will end up paying what? How do I write this?
X minus.
Careful. I do have the original price.
So wouldn't it be
0.95 minus 0.15 of 15% does not mean anything. Of 0.95, very good. And I will get whatever. This is called a decrease. And this will be the actual price.
Why are you writing 0.95 two times?
Very good. So let's come back to this problem. from the original price, I subtract 35% of the original price.
Okay.
From the original price, I subtract 0.15, which is 15% of the original price.
Okay.
You see the correspondence?
Yes.
Yes? Perfect. Okay. So this is a decrease, and that is the actual price. Can anyone give us a decrease? Because they're asking us two different things. 0.15 times 0.95 is 0.1425. And subtracted this, subtracted from 0.95. What did we get? Exactly, I got the same thing. 0.8075.
So if the bottom represents 0.1420.
This product is the decrease from the original price. The problem is asking us to determine two things.
Okay.
To determine the decrease from the original price and to also determine the actual price.
Oh, okay.
So that's why I had to determine this separate from the original, from the price. Okay. Very good. 21. And then we can move on. Right. Right. Yes, I would say 0.81. Yeah. I agree. 21. Find last year's salary if after a 4% raise, this year's salary is 44,200. So 4% raise and the result 44,200. So find the last year's salary, knowing that it was increased by 4% of what? Of the last year's salary, right? Okay, that's the base. We're increasing that base by 4% to end up with a 44,200 salary for this year. Good. So can anyone tell me what to write? X plus, very good. They're very good. 0.04 doesn't mean anything. I cannot add it, I cannot subtract it. Yes. Very good. And then? Very good. Perfect. So the base salary or the salary from last year plus, bless you, 4% of it, it's calculated on it, will equal 44,200. How do I solve this equation? Very good. Equals. Very good. And then X equals. I divide both sides by? Very good. Over? 0.04. Right? Okay. So, I'm sure you have it. What is it? So, it's 42,500. Very good. You can always go back and check. Any questions? Have we had enough of this, or we still need examples? Are we okay with this? Can we move on now? Okay, yes, let's do one more. Absolutely. Very good. Number 19. Find the original price of a pair of shoes if the sale price is $78 after a 25% discount.
Right. gonna equal, so it's gonna equal x, right? Because x would be the original price.
So the problem was saying, find the original price of a pair of shoes if the sale price is. Say it again.
X plus 0.25.
It's discounted. X minus. Minus 0.25. Very good. Equals 78 indeed. A dollar minus a quarter. 1x minus 0.25x. 0.75. Very good. X equals 78. How do I get X then? 78 by 0.75. So let's see what we get. Was it? Okay, I trust you. A 104. Thank you. So from the original price of 104, we got a 25% discount. And we ended up paying $78. I'm sorry. Do we need more examples, or are we okay with this? Can we move on to more word problems? Okay. Yes. Yes. Sure. Yes. That's okay. That's fine. Okay. 2.7. More word problems. Now, careful, here's a question for you. All these word problems transformed or changed, most of them, except I think one, changed into what? What is this old chapter all about? What are we solving? Equations. So almost all, not all of them, but almost all changed into an equation that we had to solve, right? Okay. So let's continue with more word problems. Okay. On page 144, let's start with problem 23 on 144. How can $54,000 be invested part at 8% annual simple interest and the remainder at 10% annual simple interest, so that the interest earned by the two accounts will be equal?
Breaks. I don't know if anyone can see it, but there's sparks flying out of my ears.
Equal interest. Okay, hold on. We only wrote something down. We didn't even discuss it yet. Hold on, just give me 1 second. So we have $54,000, and we take part of it to a bank somewhere on the left-hand side of Route 100, and they are giving us 8%. On what? On the amount we take there. That's all we have. We have the amount here, 54,000. We take part of it without counting it. We take it to the bank, and they are paying us 8% per year. We take the remainder. No, we don't count it. We take it to another bank, and they are going to give us 10% on that money per year. The other ones, they will give us 8% on the money we give them, we put in the bank. Exactly. So this is the amount X and this is the amount Y, correct? Because it's unknown. From 54,000, I don't look, I grab some and I go to the first bank and I know they will give me 8%. And then I take the rest without counting it, I take it to another bank and they're giving us 10%. At the end of 1 year, 365 days, we go to this bank and say, I'm not taking my money out, but just give me my interest for the year. Then we go to the other bank. I said, keep the money. So I still want to keep the money in there, but just give me the interest. And I want to make sure that these two are equal. If I get $100 here, I'll get $100 here. That's the idea. Okay, ready to think about this? So the interest for the year is calculated exactly what we've just been doing. 8% of the amount we take there times 1 year. At the other bank, 10% of the amount we put in there times 1 year. And these two have to be the same. So, since we do have two variables, how many equations do I have to come up with?
Two.
Absolutely. So, can anyone give us the obvious equation right away by simply looking at this little chart that I created? You can come up with the first equation, boom. Equals? That's it. X plus Y must be 54,000. There is no question. And now I have to set, as the second equation, two quantities equals to each other. So what is the quantity here? Don't give the money, but just give me the interest. What is the interest here?
8%.
Yes? Of?
X.
Of X. How do I write 8% of X? Because I cannot write 8%. 0.08x. Then I go to this other bank. Give me my interest. A year has passed. I just want my interest. What is it? 0.1y. Very good. Excellent. Wonderful. So now you have several options. You solve the first equation for x because we know how. And you replace x in the second equation. Or you solve the first equation for y because we know how. We studied that. And you replace it in the second one. It doesn't matter what you want to do, but you have to decide and tell me what to do. Do we want to solve the first equation for X or solve it for Y? Good. So if I solve this equation for X, what do I have to write? I want to solve this equation for X.
X equals 54,000 minus Y.
Exactly. Negative Y plus 54,000. Good. What do I do with this X now? Exactly what we did before.
Okay.
Right here. This will replace this X. Indeed. Can anyone dictate the second equation? Parentheses, I must have parentheses, negative y plus 54,000 equals, of course, 0.1y. Is this clear so far? Is it clear that we can move y to the other side as we did before with all the letters? Is this clear when moving y to the other side?
Solve for x up there, I can't move on the y over because you want to solve for x by itself.
Right. Is this clear? Is this step clear?
Yeah.
Can I replace x in here by this quantity because they are equal? If I say x or I say this, I mean the same thing. So I can replace this by this quantity. Because it equals x. Are you with me now? Everyone? Yes? So this is still 0.08. Instead of x, I have this quantity that replaces x. And the right-hand side is the same. Are we okay now? Yes? Everyone? Okay, what will you recommend next? Of course. So negative 0.08y plus 540 times 8. How much is 540 times 8? I'm lazy, as you can see. 4320 equals 0.1y. Are we okay? So 0.08 distributed to negative y is this. 0.08 distributed to this is 4320. And 0.01y stays. Yes. But I can't, because these are not like terms, but what I can do is this. Yes. So I have 4320 on the left. What do I have on the right? Yes. 0.1 plus 0.08 is indeed 0.18y. And I know how to solve this equation. I've solved so many so far. What do I have to do to both sides again? By 0.18. So I'm going to divide. I already have it here. That's why I kept it. 24000. So it appears that we took to the second bank how much from our 54,000? 24,000. And then how much did we take to the first bank then? 30,000. Is this good enough? No. I don't trust this. I have to go back and check both equations. Then I'll say, yep, this is it. Or I'll say, oops, it's not correct. So I go back to the original problem. Here's the original problem or the original system. So X is 30,000 and 24,000. 30,000, 24,000. Ready? Now, is it clear that 30,000 plus 24,000 is definitely 54 and I have no problem there? Yes? Okay. Now I have to check. I'm multiplying 0.08 by 30,000 and 0.1 by 24,000. I shouldn't even use the calculator, but let's do it. So 0.08 multiplied by 30,000 and 0.1 multiplied by 24,000. Are both equal? The left-hand side equals the right-hand side. Then what will you say about our solutions? Or I should say it's a one solution situation. So X is 30,000 and Y is 24,000. What will you say? Is it acceptable? Yep. So this is it. And this is indeed the ordered pair. We're going to talk more about this in the next chapters. Good. Let's choose another problem. Any questions for me? Not necessarily. Not at this point. I'm fine. I'm fine if you just write X and Y. You don't have to write this yet. Yes. Let's look at some trains here. 27. Suppose two trains leave Corpus Christi, Texas, at the same time, traveling in opposite directions. Okay? So they start here, and this is one of them, and this is the other. They travel in opposite directions. Fine. One train travels 10 miles per hour faster than the other. One train travels 10 miles per hour faster than the other. I need you to tell me what to write before I read on. So if this one travels at X, this one travels at? Excellent. Thank you. In 2.5 hours, the trains are 205 miles apart. So in 2.5 hours, they will be 205 miles apart. Okay. Find the speed of each train. Find the speed of each train. Okay, let's start from scratch. These two trains start at this point and they go in opposite directions. This one travels slower than this one, or if you want, this one travels faster by 10 miles an hour faster than this one. I look at my watch. I see the time. They left just this second. I look again at two hours and a half later, and I give them a call and say, hey, guys, you're exactly at 205 miles apart. You traveled 2.5 hours, 2.5 hours, and you got here. You traveled 2.5 hours and you got here. And I can measure the distance between the two of you, and you are at 205 miles apart. I want to find the speed of this train. I want to find the speed of this train. What should I write? What do I know? What equation I can think of? Anything that I could put in writing. I know the distance, very good. So I know the total distance. So I know that this was covered by one train. And I know that this, hold your thought just 1 second, hold your thought. And this was covered by the other train. So as you see, this was the starting point. This train, because it's slower, covers the brown area. And the other one is faster, so covers the red area in my graph. So I know the distance.
Time.
Say it again.
Time.
I know the time as well. So I know that this train needed 2.5 hours to get here. And this train needed 2.5 hours to get here. And I know that the total distance is 205. Any suggestions? Can you think of anything?
205.
I cannot. Yes, distance equals the rate times time, correct?
You don't know. So we're looking for the rate, you're looking for R.
I'm looking for an equation first, and then I will look at it and think what I have to do next. But right now I want to represent this in an equation.
So if you're doing distance equals rate times time.
Correct. But remember, this is done by one, this is done by the other. So you cannot combine this with this. So you can add this to this, but you cannot say that something that happens here happens here, other than the fact that it's the same amount of time.
So
yes, I'm ready.
You do 205.
Correct.
Equals
yes.
X times
plus 10 times.
Sure, that's plus 10 times 2.5.
Very good. Plus
x
times
2.5.
Excellent. So one more time. The distance of 205 is made out of two pieces. One piece where is the one train and the other piece for the other train. Now this distance can be expressed as rate times time. This distance can be expressed as rate times time. Are we in agreement with this? Yes, everyone? Yes? Okay. What do I have to do next then? What is my next step? I cannot. X plus 10 cannot be changed into X times 10. Because this is speed plus speed. You cannot multiply speeds. You cannot say 10 miles an hour times 20 miles an hour. That will not make any sense.
205
equals 2.5x plus 25. Very good. We distribute. Very good. So 205 equals 2.5x plus 25 plus 2.5x. Excellent. What will be the next step then? Before we continue, does everyone understand the equation?
So you would distribute the x into
2.5 times x is 2.5x. 2.5 times 10 is 25 plus 2.5x.
I'm so used to saying when you're trying to.
Yes. We combine like terms. 205 equals 5x plus 25. What will be the next step? Very good. Subtract 25. So I have 5x equals. How much? Is it 80? Yes? No?
180.
180. Oh, yes, of course. Good. I wasn't trying to check whether you were asleep or not. No, I just didn't put the one. my mistake, sorry. So then 180 divided by 5 is? Very good. Measurement unit, please. Thank you. Now, this is the speed of the slower train. What about the one that is faster?
46
miles per hour. Do we understand what's happening here? Do we understand the equation? Are we okay with solving it and getting x and x plus 10? Is that okay? Any questions before we look at another problem? Yes? Okay. Can I choose another now? Okay, we have investment prior situation and, oh yeah, I like that. Number 19 sounds interesting.
Number 19 on page
143. The Concordia Theater contains 500 seats. And the ticket prices for a recent play were $43 for adults, so 500 seats, $43 for each adult, and $28 for children. For one sold-out matinee, if the total proceeds were total, 16,805. How many of each type of ticket were sold? So a total of 500 seats. We sold some of them to children and some of them to adults. The prices are different, but at the end of the day, we know we collected 16,805. Two equations because we have two unknowns or variables. Let's identify them. What does X represent? Not the adults, but I know you mean. Well, I know what you mean. But the number of adults. I know what you mean. That's what you meant. What about Y? Good. Since we have two variables, yes, we have to come up with two equations. And I'm ready when you are. Let me just remind you one thing. Equations have to be consistent. I cannot add apples to peaches. So if I add money to money, I get money. Number of people to number of people, I get number of people. And I'm ready when you are. I cannot add money people to people and get money. I wish.
16
equal 5 equals x plus y.
Total amount over the seats equals
x plus y equals 500. Absolutely. It's a sold out. We are told that it was sold out. So the number of adults plus the number of kids must equal the total number of seats. Is that clear? Number of people. Total number of people. Good. Now I want money. So 43x. Very good. Must equal. Right. Is this clear? So the number of adults, which is unknown, multiplied by $43 per adult plus the number of children multiplied by $28 for each ticket will equal what we collect at the end of the day, 16,805. Do we all agree with that? Good. Are these consistent? Yes. Money plus money equals money. Number of people plus number of people equals number of people. Okay. How do I proceed? Okay, you choose. It doesn't matter. The answer will be the same. which one you would like to choose to solve for?
X.
Yes? Equals?
Would it equal 28y?
So I'm here with this equation. Yes, negative y plus 500. I like to keep it in descending order, but you're right. 500 minus y is the same with negative y plus 500. Okay, what do I do now with this? Second equation, and I replace what? This gets replaced by this because they mean the same thing. If I'm told x or I'm told negative y plus 500, I'm told the same thing. Can anyone dictate the second equation? Yes. So, no, I have to write the equation first for everyone to see. But you're right. You're way ahead of me.
43 parentheses 500 minus y.
Very good.
Plus 20 y equals 16.
Very good. Excellent. So now you're right. I have to distribute. So I have negative 43y plus, all of a sudden I'm not lazy anymore. I can multiply. So I distributed 43 to negative y. And I distribute 43 to 500 to get 21,500. And then 28y, and then 16,805 on the other side. Now, what would you advise me to do? What would you do? Very good. Negative 43 plus 28, which one is more powerful? Negative, so it's going to be negative. So negative 15y. Okay, plus 21,500 equals 16,805. Exactly, I have to move it to the other side. Negative 15y equals? All of a sudden, I'm not, okay. What is it? All of a sudden, I was not lazy anymore. So negative? 3,338? It's not possible. Because from, yeah. That's okay. So I got 4,685. Is that correct? So 5 and 9 and 6 and 4. Is that correct?
It should be
95. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's 90. It's 90. Very good. So then one more time, negative 15y equals negative 4,695. So therefore, y is 4,695 divided by 15. How much? 313. So then y equals 313. What did we denote by y? Yes. So 313 kids. Now what do I need to determine? Right. So I go back to this substitution and I replace y by 313. So then 500 minus 313 will be x, and that will be adults. Very good. So now I know that there are 187 adults in the room and 313 kids. Do I trust this? No.
Not that many kids. I'd get out of there.
Do I trust the answer? No. I go back to the original problem, to the system, right? And I replace 187, 313, 187, 313. And I check both equations, mandatory. So, yes, I know 187 plus 313 must equal 500. Yes, it is. The other one, 43 multiplied by 187 plus 28 multiplied by 313. And if I don't get 16,805, then I know something is wrong. But I got the solution to work in both equations. No one can find another, and there is no other solution but this. 187 adults and 313 kids. Any questions? Any questions? So we had three types of problems here that we looked at. Investment problem, distance, motion, we call it motion problem, distance equals rate times time, uniform motion. And this was a, how do I call this? Just a word problem, a situation in a theater. I don't know if I have a special name for this. Any questions? Would you like to see any of these one more time? Any of these three situations? Which one? The one with interest. Very good. Here it is. Let's look at the interest. Interest, interest, suppose, 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 a collection. Yeah, number 35. $3,000 is invested at 6% annual interest, simple interest. How much should be invested at 9% simple interest, annual and simple interest, so that the total yearly income from both investments is 585. Okay, let's talk about this scenario now. We take $3,000 to one bank and they give us 6% on our money of $3,000 at the end of the year. We take an unknown amount of money to the second bank and they give us 9% on our money. At the end of the year, we collect $585. How many variables we have in this problem?
One.
So I'm going to call it X. I need to write something up and solve it and get X. How will I write this scenario? Should I read the problem one more time? Yes? Very good. If $3,000 is invested at 6% annual simple interest, how much should be invested at 9% annual simple interest so that the total yearly income from both investments is 585? These go together. These go together. They are not. They're not. They're completely separate. Any suggestions?
Is the total of both of the investments is 585?
Very good. The interest from the first one plus the interest from the second one has to total 585.
So brackets both of the 3,000 times 0.06 plus x times 0.9x.
We already have it. You already said x. That's fine. So either you say x times 0.09 or 0.09 times x. Do we all agree with this situation or with this equation? Yes? So one more time. We have $3,000 in this bank and an unknown amount of money in this bank. These people pay 6%, these people pay 9%. At the end of the year, we go to the first bank and say, just give me my interest. We go to the second bank and say, give me my interest. And we go home and we count it, and it's 585. So the 3,000 times 0.06 is the interest that we collect from the first bank after 1 year. And 0.09 times X is the interest that we collect in 1 year from the second bank. And we go home and we count them and their total is 585. Is this okay? Okay, how do I solve this equation? Because I have to solve it. In this case, I only had one variable. So I multiply these two, so this is 180 plus 0.09x equals 585. How do I proceed? Subtract 180, so I have 0.09x equals 405. And now So x equals 405 divided by 0.09. So how much is, what is the amount of money that we need to take to the second bank so that we gain 585 at the end of 1 year? How much? Again, you should not trust anything. You should grab the calculator and multiply. Of course, it's clear, but I recommend you 0.06 plus 4,500 multiplied by 0.09. And if the answer is not 585, then I know I have an error somewhere. Any questions? Any questions? Okay, the last thing that I would like to do is talk about inequalities. This is the last section of chapter 2. Solving inequalities. Well, linear inequalities, to be exact. Now, can anyone tell me what this is? How do we call this? What is it? Right. Now, inequalities have one of the following four symbols. No longer equation. And I cannot change an inequality into an equation. So inequalities have these symbols. So this is the symbol of an inequality. Any of these four. Can anyone tell us how to read this symbol? Very good. Can anyone tell us how to read this symbol? Very good. Can anyone tell us how to read this symbol? Perfect. And the last one? Now one more time, the first one is less than, and here's an example. Is 5 less than 10? Good. Greater than, is 3 greater than negative 2? Less than or equal to, is 5 less than or equal to 6?
No.
It's, one of them is true. It's either less than or equal to. And the one that is less than is correct.
What does equal to mean?
The same thing.
Okay. So how is 5 the same thing as 6?
No, it's or. It's very,
okay.
Yeah.
Or. It can be less than it or it can be equal to.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
That or is the key. So this conjunction, the or, is the key. In other words, if it's less than or equal to, the statement is true. So I can write this. Is 10 greater than or equal to 10?
Yes,
because one of those two is fulfilled. Very good. Now, how do I solve an inequality is somewhat similar to the way I solve an equation. Not exactly, though. Okay. So one very important property, I would say, of inequalities that you have never seen in equations is the following. Before that, in an equation, I can add 2x to both sides, correct? I can do the same thing in an inequality. I can add 2x to both sides. Can I subtract 5x from both sides in an equation?
Yes.
And I do the same thing in an inequality. Can I multiply both sides by 5? Same thing. Can I multiply both sides by 3? Same thing in an inequality. Can I divide both sides by 5? There is only one thing, though, that I have to be careful about. Just one. Here it is. Would you agree that 2 is less than 10? Let's say for some reason we want to multiply both sides by negative 1. Multiply both sides by negative 1. 2 times negative 1 is? 10 times negative 1 is? But be careful now. Look at the real line. Here's 0, here's 2, here's 10. Here is negative 2, and bless you, and here's negative 10. Can I still keep, yes. Can I still keep this inequality symbol?
No.
So I have to flip it to the opposite. So this is the only thing that is different.
Because it's closer to the positive side.
No. Yeah, if you want to say that, you can. But normally, the way we explain this is this number is always smaller than this number, which is smaller than this number, which is smaller than this number. So
the closer you are to zero, the bigger you are.
No. This number on the left, if I compare these two numbers, this will always be smaller than this, no matter where zero is.
Because it's negative.
It's on the left. No. So it can be here negative with negative, or it can be here positive with positive. If it's on the left, it's smaller than the one on the right. Has nothing to do with zero.
No, but I said the one on the left, that side is negative, and this side is positive.
It doesn't matter. The process is the same. If it's on the negative side or positive.
Side is.
Yes. The left number is always smaller than the right number. So then negative 2 now becomes bigger than negative 10. Okay, I got the message. So I'm expecting you to complete everything till here. I will assign homework, and I'm going to finish up, hopefully, everything that I have to grade for you. And we have to talk about the second test. So we're going to finish this on Tuesday. Thursday, we're going to review. So the following Tuesday is our next test. I'm looking, I don't know where my phone is. Can anyone tell me what is the next Tuesday? Not this coming Tuesday, the following. So I think it's the third, the fourth, is it the 11th? Okay, so test 2, chapter 2, the 11th. So not next week, the following Tuesday. So I think 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 7, yes, the 11th. So, yes, go ahead. No, that's all I needed to say.
And you put that on Canvas, right?